Welcome to the other side of the world. We're going to be, well, of course, always do magic unicorn cards first, and then we'll be organizing my stash of knitting needles. It's been a while since I've gone through, checked the sizes, put things into an organized sort of system, pile, collaboration. So one moment here and I'll get the chat up. All right, there we go. Hey, Sunshine, good to see you. All right, scoot my chair in a bit. Turn it on all messages. There we go, all set up. Bring the microphone a little closer. So I'm almost done with this little knitting sock and helix knitting. I just got to knit the toe for it, and then I'll be able to reclaim these needles. I want to cast on. I've been just itching to cast on a new project. I have what's called startitis. It's where you want to start something new, and I need this size of knitting needle to do it. But I might be able to organize my knitting needles and then find another one of that size. Sorry, some fuzz there. That's right, Sunshine. You're always first to my chat. Because, again, that's why you're first on the list. You're most loyal. So before we get into organizing knitting needles and before I forget, I will do magic unicorn cards. I haven't been catching very many of Robbie's live streams. I've either been on a slightly different sleep schedule or he's on a slightly different sleep schedule or work schedule or live streaming schedule, because usually I catch him right before I fall to sleep sometimes, like his coffee live stream, and I've been missing those completely. I think I've been going to bed early. So it's probably my fault. All right, so I've got my little list here. I think we should just bump Robbie back to his place after Yarny People too. See, because it's kind of like Sunshine, the most loyal to my chat, Yarny People, then Convoy Circle People. That's how I've got it kind of organized. All right, Sunshine, here is your card for today. Best friends, true friends stick together no matter what. Next up is Amanda. Amanda, exercise. Run, walk, swim, or otherwise move your body, and this will help get you more energy and happiness. Always a good suggestion. It's really rainy and gloomy and blowy and nasty outside today. Very stormy. Today is not a good day to go outside and exercise. Then we have Jessica. Just be yourself. You're a great person. Enjoy being yourself. Then we have Tank. Tank, it's okay to be different. You don't need to be like everyone else. You're perfect just as you are. Then Robbie, practice. The best way to get good at a skill is to practice, practice, practice until you get it right. That could definitely apply to your poster making skills. You definitely need to practice, practice, practice. And then Mrs. ABD, thankful. Think about the people and things you are grateful for. So there is today's unicorn cards for those who wish to have one drawn for them. If you pop up in my chat and you would like a unicorn card, just speak up. If you'd like to be added to the list for me to pull one for you every time, just leave a comment if you're watching the playback, or speak up into the chat sometime and I'll add you to the list. Thank you, Sunshine, for always encouraging the daily unicorn cards. and your obsession with them. We're going to do something a little different this week too with them. We're going to do like unicorn cards 2.0, but not today. Because my brain's kind of a jumbled mess until I cast on a new knitting project. Like, I'm just obsessively focused on that. So that's why we're going to organize some knitting needles so that maybe I can find the size that I need to cast on a new project. And sorry about that. I'm a little stuffed up because of the weather. So not only do I have knitting needles, but I have like knitting needle accessories that are kind of all jumbled up. And I kind of have this catch-all metallic tray that sometimes will catch knitting needles, sometimes will catch other things. So I'm just going to set that aside so some of those things can get put away. Another little container with little odds and ends. That's some odds and ends. And then I have these kind of pouches that have knitting needles in them. And most of them should be organized from the last time, but we're gonna look for any stray knitting needles. Ones that have lost their place, because the other day I was looking for a crochet hook, and usually I keep all my crochet hooks in this pencil pouch, but I opened it to discover that it was empty. So this is some more knitting needles here. See how there's just, oh look, there's a couple loose strays floating around in here. I'm just going to kind of move these a little bit to the side here so you can see how they look on the inside. So it has all the sizes on a little ribbon labeled to it. And these knitting needle cases are made by, I think, Dahlia. It's been so long since I've had them. It's the same as this one here, and I think this one has a label. Yes, Dahlia Q makes these knitting needle cases with the label of the sizes. So there has been a time that I've gone through and organized things and put things away, but then things have wandered, like these here. And as soon as I find my knitting needle gauge, we'll put these back in the right spot. See, because I'm going to put all the kind of strays over here into this little magnetic sort of tray. And see, here's some crochet hooks. So we're just going to get the empty bag of crochet hooks. I don't know how or why they escape, but start to put them back in their correct place. Yeah, there are so many kinds of knitting needles, Sunshine. These are all called double point needles because they have a point on each end, mostly for socks and mittens, which I like to knit the most of. And in here we have birch wood, we have aluminum, we have anodized aluminum, we have some plastic ones here, we have some stainless steel and some rosewood and probably some bamboo over here on the under end. So they're also made from different materials. And this here is a mostly organized container. I'm going to pull it out just in case any of them gone astray. These are all my straight needles. And I just have them all together because while I say I don't have many, some people would say this was quite a bit. And these are different than, let me pull out that DPN again. So double pointed needle, DPN, double pointed needle for having a point on each end. A straight needle does not have a point on each end. It has a point on one end and then a flat end on the other side. So sometimes it will have this little flat like thing. Sometimes they'll have a little plastic flat end on it and the point on one end. Sometimes they'll have like a little ball on one end. So those are called straight needles. versus DPNs that have a point on each end. And the difference is usually a straight needle, you're only knitting one direction back and forth, so you're able to flip it around, where a DPN is usually used in a circle, so you're needing a point on both sides. Hello, Sable, good to see you. So I will just put the lid back on this, just so I don't spill it. And we'll just open it if we find any straight needles that have gone astray. Kind of make a mountain, because there are still many more to find here. And sometimes I'm finding things like pencils, which don't need to be in my knitting needle box. Ah, and see, and then we have some unopened needles. We probably have actually quite a few unopened needles. Or singular needles. So we'll be organizing these things and putting them away as well. This is a sample card from a yarn company, so this doesn't need to be in here either. This looks like just a little card someone wrote me. Okay. Someone wrote me and offered me a free pattern, but I don't remember who they are or how long ago the note was written. And then I have this little container here, which I think is empty. I got this in Disneyland here in Tokyo, and it has the guy from Beauty and the Beast, Gustav, and he, like, the character just cracks me up. So I thought maybe I would put like little stitch markers in this container or some other little knitting notion. So we'll just set that up here, kind of where we have knitting notion containers hanging out. Well, Sunshine, I have lots of knitting needles because often I'll start projects and then not finish them, and so the needles usually stay with the project. Or I have gotten, like, I really loved for a long time this brand called Brittany, these Brittany Birch needles, and so I bought a whole lot of them because I only could get them. I lived in Canada at the time on Manitoulin Island, and I only could get them if I took a 7-hour drive to Toronto each way. So I kind of stocked up the times I was in Toronto. But since then, I have migrated into liking stainless steel needles from either Haya Haya or Knit Picks. Haya Haya is my favorite, and then Knit Picks is my second favorite. Then sometimes knitting needles have come into my possession because I wanted to try them out. Like, these are knitting needles made out of driftwood, and I hadn't tried them out yet. So sometimes they end up that way. And that's how you end up with so many. Sometimes you end up with so many, like over here where you see them in the case, where you've had maybe a set, and then somewhere along the way you've lost one. So I believe I have another whole empty case here. Yes, I have an empty case. I believe this is going for, though, a mix of circular needles and maybe DPNs. So I have an empty case that maybe we'll use. I'll set that aside. And then this here, which might not show up on screen and seems to have a tape measure stuck to it, is my container of knitting needle straights that are too long to fit into this plastic case. So they're too long to fit over here. So they're in this kind of canister, and like, that's just where they are. They're very long knitting needles, and some are wood. And some are different kinds of metals. And some are plastics, but they're very long. They're too long to fit over here. So that's how they ended up in this canister. And I have a really giant set here. These are also called like a vampire steak. This is a size US 25 mil. Well, it's a 25 millimeter or size 50 US. So they're really big, like for a bulky project. So they are all in this canister. So we'll set this canister kind of off camera for a bit. Yeah, and I probably, if I'm going through this, I was talking the other day that I had some needles made out of that airplane, the same as the B-52 bomber. I might end up finding those. I think I gave them to my friend who's the aerospace engineer because I didn't like them, but I might still have them. And then I find that I've got like oddballs, like thread in here, which doesn't need to be here. I have another little canister for Notions. So this is actually Beauty and the Beast. So maybe we'll put something in here. So we'll just set that up there until we get to sorting Notions. I have like a strange Ziploc baggie. I have no idea why. So we'll just put that. I kind of got like, here we go. I've got a box over here of like miscellaneous stuff I've discovered in my room that doesn't belong anywhere else. And then this is a really cool knitting needle case that I had made for me. I don't mind that it shows my name because you guys have seen it before. So I had a gentleman tool this leather, like tool it and dye it and do all this leather work on the outside. This was my very first knitting needle case I ever had. And I had him kind of stamp the sizes inside as best as possible. And then at the time, that was my favorite brand of knitting needles. So I had a very special like set that I knit almost everything with. So it kind of had its own slot. And then like some miscellaneous spaces. So I'll probably actually empty this one out and oil this leather. I think that's an excellent idea. Go do that right now. I'm just gonna put all these needles over here in the miscellaneous. And I have a lot of these like really fine, almost like thread-like needles. Because I was really into knitting with really fine yarns when I lived in Canada. Like knitting with sewing thread. Because why not, I guess. So anyways, I'll pull those out. And I'm not into that anymore. So those are called knitting pins. Those really, really super fine ones. Are longer knitting needles harder to use? No, like you can use them for making like parts of a sweater. That's what I use them for. Or like anything bigger than a scarf that you want to knit flat and then put the pieces together. So there we go. That's all empty. I'm going to set this aside so that I can like clean the leather and oil it because it's been setting a long time. So yeah, that's a knitting needle case I have. And then for some reason, I've got a bunch of cotton thread here with my needle. So that also can go somewhere else. I seem to have a couple different weights of it for different things. I mean, it's always handy to have cotton threads around in your house for different tie different things, but that's not where they need to live. Then I have another little Disney container. So I'll just put that up here with our miscellaneous soon to sort knitting notions. I have rubber bands in here and I kind of remember why these are in here. When I originally sorted all this mess, so all of this was not sorted the last time I sorted it. When I originally started sorting this mess, I organized the sizes and had them rubber band together until I got kind of the mess under control. I don't think I need those anymore, so I'll put those into like our stationary stuff. Looks like here's a little pair of scissors. Here's a partial pack of knitting needles. Here's some new packs of knitting needles. This is a circular needle. And then it looks like I've got some pieces of paper here too. So I'll just set those aside. And then some more. Oh, someone was asking me about square needles the other day. Here is two of a DPN set. I might find more. So they're the square needles. I didn't like them. Like, I bought a set. I tried them. I think I tried a bigger set too, like a bigger gauge. And I just didn't like them. I didn't like the texture and how they would kind of flip in your hand and not roll smoothly. All right, some more stitch markers. Another pair of scissors. Looks like I have a little travel bag here, so I'll set that aside. I have this tape measure, which I'm gonna roll up. So I always like to roll a tape measure from the largest number on the inside, so that when you use it, you don't have to unroll the whole thing. And I'm sure I will find more tape measures. All right, so get this rolled up, and then we'll just kind of tuck it into one of those little Notion boxes so it doesn't drop and get unrolled. All right. Have a little star, a little metal tin that's a star. So I think like from Mario Kart sort of thing. Some more packs of unopened needles. Another roll of, these are sorted already. So that's just like this roll here. These are both already sorted out. All the sizes. And what I have to be careful for is not to tip them upside down or they'll all slide out. So these were just crayon cases, color crayon cases that someone made for like, or colored pencil cases someone made for like children. And I just bought them to sort knitting needles. So you can see I kind of have a little bit like where I've changed how maybe I've organized them over time, where I've labeled them myself with sizes. And then, you know, I crossed out maybe a previous version and reorganized it into different sizes. I kind of don't like that it has kind of the scratched out part, but it works. So just roll that back up until we figure out more of what we got and what we're doing. All right, and then looks like we got like just some loose stuff. I have some kind of weird number tags for some reason. I can't remember what I ordered them for, but they're in here. So I'm not sure. I think I was looking for something for that I could label for gauge swatches. So I'm just gonna set this aside in stationery stuff. I've got some more rubber bands, which I'm going to put here in stationery stuff. So So this is kind of what's left of my messy bucket. So I'm just going to get all this out. I could just some big handfuls and drop it in the middle. It's going to look like a big chaotic mess. See a bunch more unorganized needles. Kind of just put them over here in our tray. Some labeled but not sorted needles. Another crochet hook. I have a vintage knitting needle. A couple of those that kind of came to me with... Sometimes when people hear that you are a knitter and they have a relative that passes away, they'll give you their relative's stash. And so that's how I've acquired that. Okay, and I've got weird notes with Japanese addresses on it, so I'll just go throw that away. And it looks like we've got some receipts in here that I'll take a quick look through. There's a little pack of sewing needles. It looks like I got some ball bands too and some stickers because why not? And then our ticket when we went to Tokyo Disneyland. Here's a stitch marker. Some more needles. Some more unopened needles. Some more Tokyo tickets. A really cute stitch marker. There's one more of those square needles. Another handwritten address note. And now I know what the address note's for. It was our address where we live. So when my daughter first started going to, the younger one, when she first started going to elementary school, I made her like a necklace, like a name badge necklace with her address in it so she wouldn't get lost. All right, there we go. The whole bucket's empty now. Feel like that's enough work. Like, all right, we're done. Let's quit. Let's go take a nap. All right, so there's circular needles. There aren't many here because I used to not have a lot. And here in Japan, I bought a whole laundry basket's worth off from auctions. I have more circular knitting needles than I need in a lifetime. But they're all contained to that laundry basket. And they're already organized by size. So these are kind of just like my extra spares. And now I just dumped out those crochet needles. Which, this is not all the crochet needles that I own. So I'm still missing like my stash of crochet needles somewhere in my house. Like I have a few here, but I have like a pencil bag full of crochet hooks. So we'll just put that up there. And as we find crochet hooks, we'll just drop them off up in there. So I have a mystery to solve of where did my crochet hooks go? So this is where I have my circular needles sorted. They are by size. Oh, we forgot to find a needle gauge. Huh. Well, we cannot do much without a needle gauge, folks. That's important. And I did not see one, but I kind of know where I have one. So hold on, just moving a couple things to get to it to make sure I don't knock anything down. Set those up there. Well, these actually, I don't need the needle gauge yet because they should say so on the string, on this cord. So let's flip this around here so we read it upside down. So this is says you can't see it, you guys, because it's so small for you, but it says US size 7. So that's over here. And these are, you have to kind of wrap them around like this. And then slide them in sideways. So that's right here, US size 7. and then it could go in there. This one here should also have its size on it if it hasn't rubbed off in time. Looks like it's rubbed off in time, so I'll have to get the needle gauge. These are Addie Turbo lace tips. The missing needle gauge. Oh, is that one of the yarn cutty things, the round medallion looking thing? Yes, it was when we passed by it. One of those clover yarn razor things? Yes. Oh, and since you're here, Amanda, this is the purple juice from earlier. So it's got a bunch of vegetables in it. See the picture of all the green vegetables it has, and then it has some fruit. So that's the purple juice. Ta-da! The handy dandy trusty needle gauge. Because this is essential for sorting DPNs, because most DPNs, double pointed needles, will not have their gauge information on it. So this is a 4mm or a US size 6. Which is right over here. So you kind of have to twist them like this. Crash a bunch of things. And then put it in the side. And I just realized that this one over here that I put away, it was a US size 7, not a US size 10.5, 7mm. So US size 7.5. It was looking wrong when I put it over there. But I was just trusting myself. You should never trust yourself. Should always double check things. So this one will now go in the side and be in the right spot. And I believe this was all the circular needles we had to sort and organize. So this can get wrapped up and put away. We have these couple up here sticking out, but that's okay. Besides the whole big laundry basket. Let's just make sure they're all double point or circular needles. Yes, that's a circular needle there. And I know this one on top is. So we'll just tuck that down like that. Fold it up and contain, confine everything to its containment. Look, see, we finished the job together. Does the purple juice mix good with other beverages to make it more fun? I'm sure you can mix it with like sparkly carbonated clear liquid, like either Sprite or 7-Up or just seltzer water or a sparkly lemon water, anything that would taste good with fruit, because it has, like, you're not going to get that, like, two different kinds of sugar contrasting. You know how that is with some juices that will use, like, artificial sweeteners, and then you mix it with, like, a sparkly beverage, which has a different kind of sugar, and then it's horrible. It has no extra sugar in it. So, yeah, you could definitely mix it with a sparkly beverage. All right, I'm going to put these vintage knitting needles in here too, just so they're kind of tucked away somewhere. Because they are circular needles as well. We're going to put that back into the box. Stickers do not need to be in our knitting supplies, so we'll go put those over in stationery. And we're going to need this handy trusty knitting needle gauge very soon. But let's try to pull out any straight needles that have wandered and put them in their big straight needles container. Okay, good night. See you next time. Oh, I'm so glad. So, you had yogurt, raspberries, and cornflakes. That sounds very delicious. I did go and slice up bananas, strawberries, and put them like on a plate, and then sprinkled blueberries and some peanut butter chips, and then melted chocolate and put it over all of them, and then put it in the freezer for a bit, and then ate that right before I live streamed. So I can't even show you because I ate it, because I don't eat on live stream. And I knew I couldn't show it and then like be like, okay, well here you see it, and then be like text 10 seconds later like bye. All right, so these little pieces of paper are going to go where I've got little pieces of paper. This is a yarn band which does not belong in our knitting needles organization. Oh, my package has left Sweden. That's cool. Did you see my cool leather knitting case, Amanda? Knitting needle case. I had this made for me. So it has little buckles to buckle, and it was all tooled and handmade by a fellow that I had make it for me. So it has all the size marks in it, but I've cleared it out so I can like condition the leather because it's been so long. Like wash it and condition it. All right. This is a knitting needle notion, so we're just going to shove that up there until we sort those things out. Same for that thing there. These are some weirdly large DPNs. Here's a straight needle for our straight needle container. And the straight needles might be like outgrowing their space. And then I guess decisions will have to be made. What kinds of decisions? I do not know. Maybe we will dump them out and find any mismatched needles, and they shall depart from our company. Another yarn ball band. So, Amanda, I ordered that order that I told you for knitting needles. I ordered this, some of these, like this, probably in these exact sizes. So, if I had just not ordered needles and instead went through what I already had, I would have found what I was looking for. Oh, yeah, I pretty much ordered all these exact same things there. It could take 30 days to get here. So I pretty much could have shopped my stash and found what I was looking for instead of just being lazy and ordering online. And this could be thrown away. Why is this plastic bag here? Oh, this is some more DPN. So we'll put these over in the to sort out. They don't need to be in a plastic baggie together. Some more DPNs here. So that's kind of what's ending up over here now in the tray is just DPNs. There's a Renegade crochet hook, a lost DPN there. A broken rubber band in the trash. So see, we're uncovering what's going on here pretty quickly. These knitting needles here, oh, there's a stitch marker, came from the dollar store here, and I bought a few to teach people with because I was teaching people knitting before the global pandemic. And then we weren't allowed to visit each other. So my lessons for teaching people to knit kind of ended, which was sad because probably learning to knit during lockdowns would have been very helpful to people who were confined to their homes. Because we were confined to our homes the first time for 3 months, we weren't allowed to leave except grocery store as long as it was in 3 kilometers, work, which everyone was either on half schedule or working from home, or school would shut down. So pretty much people were stuck at home. But that's okay. So I'm just going to add them to the stash, and then as if I ever do teaching again, then I'll just pull them from my stash for people and give them to people. No, it's okay, Sunshine, that the order's still coming through. And, Amanda, I really don't need more yarn to come in either. I didn't tell you that, I have like four of those big, you'll see when they come. I have lots of yarn in process on the way in the mail. And I have to remember tonight, like, 8 p.m. my time, 8 p.m. Japan time, to check up on that auction for that spinning wheel. So far, no one's bid on it. So I don't want to jump on bidding on it and then drive up the bid. So I have to, like, I should set an alarm on my phone for that. All right, so some more knitting needles for the straights container. And then I think, oh, what's this? Sticky notes. Yarnology sticky notes. Huh. This doesn't look like something I would buy. Did I maybe I got a gift from something? Somewhere? I do not know. Well. We will disassemble this and put things away. So I guess I've got some little yarn sticky notes. Some more DPNs here for us to sort out. A Renegade crochet hook, which now it's bothering me. Where did all my crochet hooks disappear to? Got a little pile of DPNs going on over here. A solo DPN in a package. This is some straights we're going to dissect here soon. That's kind of what's on this side, straights to dissect. And look, we've almost kind of sorted all the different types. Hi, Robbie. Good to see you. If you rewind, you will find the your unicorn card. Yours, actually, I remember yours, Robbie. Yours was practice, like practice makes you better. And I made commentary how, yes, if you practice more on your sign making, you would get better. But, you know, you can apply it to something else. And this is another set of straights here. So I don't think they're all going to fit, but I'm going to try to put the lid on and maybe shake them a little. Oh, it might work, you guys. It's very close. All right, well, there you go. A very tightly packed straight knitting needle. So put that back in the box. So bring up kind of all that we've got going on with DPNs. So we have this little pouch here, the one in the background, and this one here. Hello, Bob. Good to see you. Bob Cox. You have a great evening too, sunshine, and thanks for hanging out for a bit. Right, so let's see what we got for sizing. So here in the background, we have sizing 2 millimeter to 6.5, and maybe some that are a bit over. This one here, which seems pretty thin. Remember, don't turn these upside down. They do spill. Has a lot of the finer needles, 2.0 to 5.0. And I think this is the one that I've been pulling needles from the most. I remember that this one, the Apple one we looked at, was some of the larger sizes, like from 3.75 up. So this one's kind of like the continuation of that one. And I think this one's just like overflow. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is like a second round of the smaller sizes. I guess we could put it up there as these get full. I think I'm gonna leave the nitpicks ones that are in their own case on their own. This is kind of like my swatching kit. And I'm gonna see if I could find a set of this one here that's kind of missing, which I'm sure I do have. Like in a singler right here. So I could kind of just replace that spot. And of course, one always gets stuck. So just double checking, because again, don't trust yourself. US 1, 2.5, US 1, 2.5. This is empty, so I can throw that away. So I'm going to take this kind of oddball one out and stick it kind of over here. And then put a full like package set here. They should all be the same, but just in case. So now we have a complete swatching set. So this one singular needle by itself, it's a US 2.25. So I have that spot right here. So I'm just going to take it out of this pouch so I can throw it away. And I do have a lot where they'll be like just a singular needle because these sets come with 5 needles, and usually you only need 4 for socks or mittens. So 2.25 US size 1 goes right here. This is another singular one. This is a US 0 2.0, which is over here on the end. Right, and then I think I'm going to keep these spare packs that are just new and not opened off to the side on their own. And I think I'm going to treat these. I think I'm going to cast on something with these driftwood needles today. So I'm just going to kind of put them like in my line of sight up there. And then this here is some miscellaneous needles in this bag. So we'll sort that out. So I'm going to put those Chia Goos over there. This is the brand that I like, Haya Haya. And one of the things I like about them, I don't know, I like the way how they feel. And then I like that on the edge of them, they usually have the size printed. And they're always nice because they give you a free stitch marker. Like it's just a really simple, see, there's a short one there. Usually a free stitch marker we'll put into our notions. And then sometimes I think they give you a free pattern with the high needles. So yeah, it's a free pattern they give you. They give you the URL to it and to, like, pretty much just to size a needle to make them. So they give you free patterns with their needles. I've never made any other patterns, so I cannot comment on them, and I probably will just throw this away because they probably have listed on their website like free patterns. So let's get out our trusty little needle gauge here, double check the sizes on these and put them away in the right spots. So these are 2.5. That's a 2.5. 2.25. And this little short one, also a 2.25. This is a set of bamboo needles here. These are 2.5. I'm just going to take them out because I don't like this kind of packaging. And this isn't also my favorite kind of needle. I'll just put them in their little spot here. And then throw away the packaging. And I might keep these Britneys in their original packaging. I'm sitting up there while I think about it. So this here is a sewing needle, which I do not need in my knitting stuff, but I kind of need to like secure that one loose needle. And I think there's a sewing needle at the bottom of my little magnet tray here that I'll end up putting into this little container too. So let me just get this knitting needle kind of pinned down so it doesn't fall out and poke or stab anyone or thing. And then we'll find a different place to put sewing needles. So here we are to the bulk of sorting. We're going to try to do all the smaller needles first, and it's pretty much just a matter of stabbing and putting it away. And those ones that I pulled out of the leather case that are knitting, like the really super thin ones, these ones here, I'm just going to put them all in the 2.0. I don't have my super finer gauge with me. I'm just going to stick them all over there. Which I believe, yep, all those are. You can't get the chat to load on your TV. I'm so sorry, Robbie. I do not have any reason. So you probably don't see it at all. But here on the Haya is where the labeling is. So this is a 2.25. 2.25 is like my favorite size for socks. That's a 2.75. So see how this 2.75 is getting full? So I'm just going to put it up there in that one. Restarting is always the solution, Robbie. If something isn't working, just restart. So I know these ones, you guys, oh yeah, you can kind of see them. Those, like these bigger ones, I know are going to go into this bigger case. So I'm just kind of setting them aside now while we do all the kind of smaller ones here. So the square ones also have their sizing written on the label, I do believe. They are 2.25. Right, this one here, 2.5, 2.25. 5. So this one here is a 4.0, which I think, yeah, see my 4.0 spot's kind of crowded here. So I'm going to put these with the bigger one until we unroll the bigger one. It really does make a difference. I don't have it handy, Robbie, but I'm about to do another gauge swatch sort of thing because that's kind of what I'm in the mood for. And when I finish it, I'll show it on live stream or at least keep it handy so I could like pull it out. Like I did one last summer for a yarn brand, like just like I think I did like 4 different sizes of needles, and you could see like the difference of how much the size of the knitted square was at the end. And when you're doing like knitting math, it can make a big difference because, you know, while a square is only, you know, a couple inches, if your math is wrong for a hat, it makes the difference of like the hat not fitting at all. So that's why like needle size and gauge swatch is so important. So you, or, you know, if it's a sweater or anything, like one number off on that sizing calculation and for each repeat, because, you know, you're repeating that number over and over. Can make the item not fit at all. It could be a sweater too big or a sweater too small or a hat too big or small. This is a 2.75. It's labeled on there. It's kind of overflow on that one, so we'll just put it up there. And then for something like socks, which is what most of these are, sock mitten needles and some hats, you know, like it's the difference of your sock being too tight or too loose. So you want to make sure you have socks that fit properly. So it's not only a size of the needle, but also the size of a yarn, because yarns are different sizes too. And yarns could be labeled the same. Like there's basically, oh, you're restarting to fix it. Good. So like yarn companies will use the same name for a size of yarn, but they're between two companies that might be different sizes. It's just like that's why you go to a shoe store and you try on the shoes, right, Robbie? Because like different shoes fit different ways. So you want to try them on before you buy them. Sort of the same kind of ish concept when it comes to yarn is you want to try on the different sizes because not all yarn companies make yarn equally. Like same thickness of thread. This is a 3.5. And I don't know how it ended up in here, but I have 3 of the bamboo skewers from doing the eggs. Put those aside. Can they be thrown like knives? So, Robbie, have you seen that little short of someone like flicking a toothpick and it like stabbing into the wall? So yeah, I guess if you're skilled enough, like you could throw them like little poisonous darts or the person who does throwing the toothpicks. I mean, they are pretty sharp. And you're allowed to fly with knitting needles on the plane. These, like, this is a stainless steel sharp point on each end. Object that's, you know, I can't like bend it really, and I'm allowed to fly on an airplane with that. Everyone's allowed to fly on an airplane with that. mean, you're allowed to take a big needle like this on the airplane. This is knitting needles are allowed on airplanes. So I mean, this isn't like the sharpest of points, but it could get the job done. If only there was, knitters on the 9/11 planes. Maybe the outcome would be different. Who knows? That's a 2.0. Go stick that over there. That's going into our little notions pile right there. Here are some of these like little wire ones. Markers. There's that sewing needle that I said I threw in my little tray, my little magnetic tray. I'm gonna put this sewing needle away. There you go. So sewing needles are secure. Put them away in sewing area later. Okay, all that's left in the tray now is big ones. These are big ones. So these are all the small ones we have to left to sort. So good progress. There we go. Did I ever? I'm sure there's a universe where train needle assassins on a plane. I saw that Cadmus Rex got unbanned. I think they made amends in Telescope. Telescopes was live streaming the eclipse because I woke up at like 3 in the morning our time and caught part of the eclipse, like just as it was starting in Mexico. And then saw Telescope was live streaming it from his backyard and saw a bunch of people over there, including a lot of Troll Central folks and Cadmus Rex. So that's good that they all made amends. So that goes there. Two point two five. And I haven't seen Rick and Morty since I was a child. You're still banned. Well, good, Robbie. Should just remove the temptation of going over there. I'm not banned anymore. But, I mean, I went over there and tried to talk to them about Queenie. And they were kind of like snarky.
You might have been unbanned, Robbie. You might have gotten cleared out. I don't know, though, because, Robbie, you got banned by Troll Central. I saw when that happened. Because Troll Central themselves told you to get the fuck out of there. Maybe they're trying to encourage you, Robbie. Go make new knitting, new live stream acquaintances on the internet. All right, so we're down to just the last few here. I don't think Telescope was ever banned. There was just a conflict. And Telescope was stubborn and left and did not return. Well, at least, Robbie, you don't have a bunch of alts named after different kinds of vegetables. I saw that Broccoli had done that. I mean, whatever amuses and entertains you, I guess. See, like, this one has the size written on it, but you guys can't see that. I barely can see it. It says 2 millimeter. It is correct. So 2.5 is getting very full over here. So I'm going, and it's getting kind of full over here, but I've got a little overflow spot here. The last one here, and we have some big ones to sort out. So I think Brox made a alt named something with a zucchini, and I think he made an alt named something with a carrot, and it was the other night when he was over in Tommy Tempers, and I guess he got timed out for 24 hours on his main account. And then started coming in with a range of alts with funny, like, kind of quirky vegetable names. Not just, like, zucchini, but, like, something else. I think he had, like, 3 or 4 alts with vegetable names. All right, so now we're going to deal with the bigger needles that I did not sort. And they might not fit here. So we're going to roll this one up. Kind of set it to the side. Because I think some will fit down here. Oh, I'm sure he has more. I mean, how many alts do you have, Robbie? I mean, I've got a few alts. But I don't know. I think at some point, like, just stop messing with the same people over and over. I don't know. I've been watching a lot of different kind of content. So I have these three needles. which seem to be a 6 or a 6.5. It's kind of in between, but I don't think I could fit them in the 6.5, so I'm going to try to fit them here in the 6. But if I do not have a fourth one, then I do not know why I have them. Oh, and see, they're kind of too long for in here, too. Let's back up a bit here. Think about this a little bit here. Maybe put these weird, strange, giant aluminum needles off to the side a little bit here. Like these oversized aluminum ones. Okay. Make a plan for them and deal with kind of what remains of this little pile here. This kind of medium aluminum. What are you? God, no, no. I think Robbie F just like wandered different directions here on these YouTube streets. That's a 5.0, a size 8. See, and I have 4 to 6. And I jumped 5.0, which is here. All right, that's good. This one here, 3.75. This is a 2.5 that didn't get put away. Now it is. This is a 5.0. And there's a bit of a 4.5 overflow over there. So, good. All right, so just this handful left. Throw away the little screw. And then the big giant ones. And then all knitting needles have been sorted out. Three seven five is pretty full over here too, and over here. Oh good, we can fit one in. What am I doing with the extras? There's no such things as extras, Robbie. All right, I will explain this in man terms, construction terms. Robbie, if you were in the construction field, would you have just one hammer? Would you have just one type of screwdriver? Why don't you only need one set of each? No, Robbie, because see what happens is you start a project and then you don't finish the project and you should leave the knitting needles in the project and go and start a new project. And you should start dozens and dozens of new projects over your knitting lifetime and have like a big container of unfinished projects. That is the way. So you need a variety of knitting needles to start the new projects that then you're going to leave the knitting needles with the project when you go start a new project. And you need a variety of sizes because you never know what size your project is going to need. Like what size a knitting needle, your yarn and project going to need. Like one project, one yarn, you could try 4 or 5 different sizes till you find the right one. So that's why you always need a variety of sizes and multiples. Now we have these big giant aluminum ones that I quite haven't figured out what to do with yet. But I was kind of just thinking if maybe there was an empty space in one of these to kind of sort them out a bit. And I think I can fit some other places. That's not quite totally appropriate, but it will work. That will not work there. Let's see what we got for space over here. All right. So I'm going to take all my 2.0s from over here and move them all into one. On this one. So they're all together. Not quite perfect, a little bit chaos, but it's okay. And then don't drop them. So 5.0 is pretty packed over here, but what about here? Oh, it's pretty packed over here too. What about 5.5? I have 5.5 here. Do I have 5.5 here? Oh, yes. Okay. So we kind of need just some spaces to put these extra big aluminum ones. And I think they're just going to kind of have to go wherever they fit. Or somewhere else. Undecided about those. Those are kind of the last ones still that don't have a place. All right, let me roll this up. Yeah, see, well, these are all like backup needles, Robbie. All right. A little bit of a ribbon loss there for a moment almost.
There we go. Put that back into my box. There. That's where we could put those. And roll them up. And then tie it off. Hoarder. Kind of probably Robbie. What if the zombies come? What I really need to do, Robbie, is sit down with each size and like just really look through like each size and purge any that I don't like anymore. That's really what I gotta do. Cause sometimes you acquire needles this way too, Robbie. Like see this little section right here? So I might have started collecting these purple ones, right? Because that's all I could get at the time. And then I found maybe one that I liked better. So it's kind of like I almost replaced it, but I didn't get rid of the purple ones. That's a lot of my knitting needle stashes. Sometimes I start it with one size and one type or style. And then along the way, I've replaced it with the style that I like. But I never got rid of the ones that I didn't like as much. All right. And this bundle is now tied. So I should look to see if they make like another, like I really like, well, no, because those tall ones stick out of it, but I really like how this kind of folds over and keeps everything from sliding around. So then this bundle, tie it up. I'm going to put my big container of tall street needles back away in there. All right. And then all I have left for needles is the ones in the packs. That I said I was going to keep that way. I think they could go in this pencil pouch. Make myself a mental note to find where have all the crochet hooks gone astray to. There, I like that there. Have this, which I'm going to do some swatching with. This, which I'm hopefully going to cast on a project with. So I'm just going to set those aside in my little tray here. So now I just have knitting notions. Which I guess there's some more sewing needles in here. So I'm just going to stick this in with the other sewing needles just so all sharp, stabby sewing needles can stay together. And it looks like I've got a straight pin in here. This looks almost like some weird conglomeration of just a bunch of little metal things. And I don't know why there's this piece of fabric in there. Oh, and there's a magnet in here. Well, that's very handy. So these are yarn needles, and they can stay with knitting stuff. Okay, these are yarn needles. These are not yarn needles. So this little Tokyo Disney container is going to hold some sewing notions that seem to have wandered astray. There we go. Any other sewing notions we find, we'll just put in here. Put that over there. Some trash. I don't know why there's a magnet here. There is some more yarn needles, some scissors, a tape measure, a stitch marker, some more yarn knitting needles. There's more. there's always more, Robbie. You gotta have all your other tools. If anything, Robbie's learning he's never gonna have a girlfriend who knits or crochets. All right. So I have some stitch markers that I received as gifts that I don't think I want. Like, they're not the kinds of things I like. Maybe I should make like a little pile of pass these along to someone else sort of things. Right, and this is a knitting needle case, which should only have knitting needles in it, but let's just double check. Yes. Okay, I'm just going to set that aside. I kind of think this should be the new knitting needle holder, like the little like darning needles. So we obviously do not need any more darning needles in our life because we have more than enough here to last a lifetime. And then we should put all our stitch markers in Gustav's case. And then maybe our tape measure and anything like that in here. Or maybe those things go in here and stitch markers go in here. Stitch markers. Yes, okay. And little other stuff over here. Stitch markers. There we go. That's sewing stuff. These are lids for when we're all done. These are those quilting clips. I can't think of any reason why we need a big safety pin in knitting. So I seem to have some cable needles and stitch holders.
a little like pickup stitch needle. Put that in here. Yeah, I guess this will go there. And then some scissors. Okay, and then all the rest are stitch markers. But I think there's more than what will fit in this little case. And I need to take a break before we continue on. Alexa, volume 10. So I'll leave you guys with the music for a moment.
Alexa, volume 6. Alexa, volume 8. Okay, so I made an executive decision on my little bathroom break there. Needles are going to go in here. Darning needles. Probably with their little darning needle case. And then all stitch markers in here, maybe. I may have to take these out. Like so. So I've always liked these clover stitch markers. Other people like different ones, but these are the ones I like. Looks like I got an extra Hiya stitch marker over here. Just put that with my pass along to someone else pile. Two together. There we go. So, good decision. They all fit. And the lid for them. So, needles. This will go out to where sewing things are. And I think everything will fit in here for these cable needles and stitch holders, except this awkward one here. I don't know what to do with the little star. I have these things that I'll set aside, give away to someone. So now we can cast on a new project. I need to decide which of these balls I want to use. I believe they are the same colorway, they've just been wrapped differently. But I'm going to double check. Color 09. Yes, that is correct. So they've just been wrapped slightly different. But I thought about doing a helix project with them. But I do not know how that will look. All right, so this end for this yarn, hopefully, right? Oh no, it might not be. Let me pull this all out here. Okay, there is an end somewhere. There it is. All right, let's clean up this mess we've made with this one. So this one definitely starts off very peach. Let's see what the other one does. So let me wind it all up, back up. I'm a bit off camera for this. So I'm not making a good little thing here. So let me just clean this up a bit. All right. There we go. Okay, almost to the end here where we made all the yarn barf. See, this one does not have this peach in the middle, right? So that is why I'm thinking they would look good helixed together. And because I'm obsessed with the helix technique. So probably no, I just got lurkers. Lurkers, you probably don't even care because you don't care about knitting. But helix is a technique that you can make stripes without having a jogless join. It's kind of like two spirals chasing each other. And who doesn't love stripes? Moment here, I made a knot on it. So before I pull it and it gets tight, just go undo the knot. There we go.
And then this one. Oh yeah, see, this one will start probably with that pretty purple color. Maybe. Okay. Kind of move that one aside for a moment while we get this one all sorted out. I always think about like starting with this kind of more one that starts with a green for the cast on edge, but I think I'm going to start with this one that has more kind of a pink start to it. Because I think I'm going to do like a rolled cuff edge on it. It's kind of like my standard go-to, either a pico edge or a rolled cuff edge. So a rolled cuff edge, this is knitting, not crochet, so knitting a rolled cuff is you cast on like 5 rolls, and then on the 6th roll you pick up the cast on edge and knit 2 together, and it gives you like a permanent kind of rolled edge. And then if you knit a row, purl a roll, it won't kind of roll back on itself. But I don't know, like maybe, what does this recommend for needle size? It recommends a 3 millimeter. And I want it to size down at least to a 2.25. That would seem about right to me. And I'll try out, I think first I'll cast on with the metal needles, and then maybe I'll switch to the driftwood needles. Sunshine, you are not sleeping. This is not you sleeping. You were going to bed. But thank you. Pink chasing green would be pretty. I think so. I mean, the colors are going to shift. So it won't stay pink, because see how it's very colorful. But I'm going to start with this yarn, this pink. And then every other row, because they're not matching up perfectly. So one row will be this, one row will be that, one row will be this, one row will that be that. So they'll alternate back and forth. Because they didn't start the same. This one starting with a green and the orange. And this one starting with this pink into a purple.
So if you don't know, I pulled the yarn out from the middle. That's always the tidier way to knit from the middle, because then your ball won't roll around on the ground. If you're pulling from the outside, it'll roll around on the ground or wherever you have it. But when you pull, try to find the end from the middle. Sometimes you yank out some extra yarn. It's called yarn barf. And so then you kind of got to wrap it up, and I just wrap it back up on the outside edge, because then when I get through all that, then I'll start pulling from the middle. You can't fall asleep, so you've been lurking. Well, that's nice, sunshine. I understand that. Sometimes I lurk and don't type, like especially your bird thing. I saw like blue jays earlier, but I think you were on like in the middle of the night for me. I don't remember, but like I was all alone in your channel and I saw a blue jay, but I was too tired to type. But I can't remember if it was right before I went to sleep or when I woke up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. Because I woke up in the middle of the night just as the eclipse was starting in Mexico. And I watched NASA's live stream for about 15 minutes. My family member from the US wrote to me too during that time and told me that they had their second flat tire in a week. Which is a real bummer for them because they're driving Uber. So when they get a flat tire like that, it takes time to go and get it fixed, and then that's time they're not working. Got a little bit of chaos going on here with some twisting and that, but it all works out. Just never pull anything too tight. Like some stuff twisted around there. Yeah, two tires in a week. And I think the last, I don't know where they're getting tires or whatever, but I think the last one cost them $300 to fix. And so that's probably how much this one cost. The last one was a blowout though, and they were on the road. So I'm glad they were able to like safely navigate off the road, and they didn't have a passenger, but they did have someone's food order with them. So they contacted the customer. I think they're doing so. No, I know they're doing both Uber Eats and Uber People. So they messaged the person and they said the person was like really nice about it. Because they ended up putting like the donut or the spare on themselves and then continued on. Just bring my tangled mess back over here. I can at least wind some up. So I feel like I make progress. I do see the end there. Yeah, it did seem like a lot for a tire, and they don't have like a truck or anything. They just have a standard like little sedan, Nissan car. I forget which model they have, but it's just like a little four-door standard car, a couple years old. I guess I had another one yesterday. I think they were trying to tell me about it. I'm like, it's 3 o'clock in the morning here. I'm not really awake. I just went to the bathroom. And you can tell me about your flat tire later. Then I sent them the link to NASA. I'm like, do you know about the eclipse? And I sent them the links for the eclipse. Good progress there. Sometimes yarn messes just become a mess. No, not the same tire, Sunshine, a different tire. So they had two different tires, flats. Not same tire. Yeah, if it was the same tire, I would be pretty upset. But you know, sometimes that happens. You buy a new tire and you hit something and same tire and you pop it again. Could happen, but no, it was a different tire. I've only had a couple flats in my life. And they've always been slow flats too, like always a nail and always a slow flat. Though quite a few years ago, my husband had a similar thing where he had more than one flat in a week or a month or something. And it was the same thing, like a nail both times. It's funny to think, how do nails even get on the road? But they do. Yarn companies should not put knots in their yarn barf. You know what? If they didn't put a knot in it, it was from me pulling it and flipping it and stuff. It was my doing, not their doing. Sometimes though, they'll stick the tail a little bit to the outside, like the tail that's inside that you're fishing for, and then they'll put like a little flag on it. That's always nice. Even if they put a flag on it on the inside, that would be nice. Like just stick a little piece of paper on that end so you can find it. But there must be something with the way how skeins are wound up that's not very easy to do. All right, good progress there now. Wind, wind, wind. Then to the next clump that I've got all messed up. Good, good, good. Yeah, right, sunshine? Just give me a little flag or something. Little tab. Okay, so I've got the other end over there. And I've got the kind of attached to the skein part over here. And then just whatever this little blob here is in the middle to sort out. And then there we go. There's where the knot is. So let me get that. There, all right. Ta-da! We've made it! I know. And it's hard to see sunshine. But it's like actually like three colors blended into one. So this section has a pink, a light lavender, and then like a light yellow or peach color. It looks pink from a distance though, but it's really very pretty. So our handy swatching kit, now that we've organized all our needles and we don't need to wait for needles to come in the mail. Which we should have done before we ordered the needles, but whatever. More needle, the more needles, the merrier. Gonna just put a little knot here on this end so it doesn't fray too much. Then I'm gonna snip it so it looks all pretty for my own personal aesthetics. I think we're going to cast on 54 stitches. Hold on here. Because I want to be able to divide it. Where's my calculator on this phone? I just realized I have another phone. Maybe 56. Let me see. Oh, okay. 18 stitches per needle. All right. We could do that. Where did chat go? Over here. There you are. There's our other needles. Excellent. Put that over there. 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Eleven, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 18, and I'm going to adjust the pattern and do 60 stitches and 20 each needle. Alright, then we'll get the next needle here. One, two, three, four. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Double check that here. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. All right, very good. And then finally, the third needle. You're going to start calling me needles? It reminds me of Game of Thrones and Sansa Stark and her little sword she called Needle. Let's just go right here. There we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Hooray! And we make them, we join. This is really like a lesson here, but I guess I'll talk through it a bit just so I can practice maybe someday and write it up in a tutorial. All right. So once you've cast on your number of stitches you need, then you join it in a circle, a triangle circle. And you just start knitting. Easy peasy. Preferably not off camera, probably. I like to knit my tail in the first 4 stitches, just so it's nice and secure, and then I like to kind of drop it off. So we'll be knitting 5 or 6 rows and then picking up the cast on stitch. I probably will not be doing that on camera just because you kind of got to hold it close to your eye for that. And for this, I kind of have it setting a bit away, but that's okay. We'll knit the first 5 rows or so and we'll maybe wrap up. Guess I should actually pay attention to the time. Oh yeah, we're good for time. All right, there we go. So I know it's kind of hard to see what's going on because it's not much here yet and it's so tiny. But this really isn't about the knitting so much as not doing a talking heads panel. You at least have something to look at besides a talking bubble. There, see, and I'll even be nice and put the yarn more in frame so you can see it. So you have something pretty to look at. So you pretty much knit to the end of one needle, then you just rotate it and go to the next one. Alexa, skip. We'll need to listen to her, Elise. It's just such a popular song. You hear it all the time. You guys actually might not even actually hear it in the background. Do you go around both needles? No. So, Sunshine, I just was going around one when I was holding them together and casting on. I was always going around like the back one as I added each needle to spread out the stitches over like 20 stitches per needle. Good question. Okay, so now we've completed the second needle, and then finally the third one. Then it gets kind of easier. It always gets easier after your, like, that first round after your cast on round. Before we get to the end of this round here, I'm just going to set this down and prep these driftwood needles that I want to switch over to and try out. So this is from a company called Lykke, L-Y-K-K-E. If you've been around the knitting world, you'd recognize the name. They are very well known for, I think, their circular, their like interchangeable circular set. I didn't even remember they had DPNs or where I bought these DPNs from. No clue. But we have them now. And this is my only set from this company. And my first time using them. First time using any needles from this company. So, initial feedback on them is they do have their size information printed on them very clearly to see, but it also kind of has a bit of a textured surface of where that's printed. I don't know how that's going to rub on the yarn as we work. And this one's kind of got some rough patchy spots on it. So we'll see how it goes. And I might have one extra needle more than what we need. So I'm just going to set them there because as we come to the end of this one, we'll just switch out and try them out for a bit. Kind of detangle myself here. okay, these first four stitches are going to be a little tight because remember I said I include my tail in the first four stitches. So I might just give me a moment here with these needles and working that out. They are very bendy on the body. Not sure how that's going to work out in the long run. But it's like a flexi blend. Like they're kind of flexible. Like here, hold it up. Like see, they bend a little. But it's kind of flexible. And they do have a bit of a pointier tip than the stainless steel ones that I'm working with. And that's fine. I like a pointy tip. So there we go. Past those first four stitches. And the pointy tip might be helpful for picking up that cast on edge. I am very concerned about them snapping, being that they're a smaller size and they're flexible and they're wood. So we'll have to see how that goes to see if maybe they break as we go. And that would not be a surprise or unexpected. Bamboo needles, when they're small, they'll break. And I think I broke a rosewood needle before and a birch needle. So it does happen. Just kind of move this tail out of the way a bit here. Go, moved on to one. We'll just kind of drop off the metal ones as we go. This is round two, and like I said, we're going to do five rounds and then we're going to pick up the cast on edge. And make a rolled cuff, an intentional rolled cuff. So moved over to the second one. It is definitely more grippy on the body of the needle. Not even just where the painted thing is, but the whole body versus the stainless steel, which is very slippery. And that's not like a good or bad thing. Sometimes you want a little bit more of a texture, like a little bit more of a grippiness. Sometimes you like a really slippery needle. Both have their benefits. I don't like things too grippy that they can't move. I would say these are not that grippy. Just a moment here, going back a stitch. Notice I split that one. This yarn is a little bit splitty, but not too much. I've noticed this with a lot of Hobie yarns, is they're a little bit maybe more splitty than an indie dyed, but not unexpected. Okay, so now we're all the way over on the driftwood needles. We can put away the metal ones. Let's get this last one here for a working needle pulled out. Put the metal ones away since we've done all that work earlier today of organizing needles. Kind of keep everything nice and neat and organized. I'm going to put my kind of swatch kit back into my box. I'm going to put this stray needle into its container here. Just in case one snaps and you need a backup. I'll also put my knitting tray away. There, so there's just less stuff here. So switching over to these needles, it definitely made the project a lot lighter. Those stainless steel needles are a bit heavier, so it's definitely like super light now. There's a bit of sound to the gliding back and forth, gliding the stitches back and forth on the needle. And there's a bit of texture when gliding that point up to pick up that stitch, but just a bit, just a smidget. If you're really like a tactile knitter and into feeling that, they're little subtle things that you might pick up on. I'm a very tactile knitter and very nitpicky on the little fine details. So those little things can or cannot bother me. It just depends. That's why I usually like stainless steel needles, is they stay pretty consistent with like the smoothness of their texture. Unless they have a barb. And then you gotta file off the barb. So we're on our third round here. Again, not much to see. That's just how it goes. Knitting is a very slow process. It's not really the best live stream content unless you're pre-recording a video and you're going to edit out a bunch of it and speed it up quite a bit. Then I guess it could be interesting if it was a subject that interests you. Just round around Alexa volume 10. Alexa volume 10. And I'm just going to sit back here and take a little bit of a rest and knit. So that's pretty much it. Just knit, knit, knit in a circle. And I would say, oh, when this is finished, there'll be a blah, blah, blah. But I don't think this project will make it to finish. I think it will be a temporary fancy, a novelty of sorts. Snag on this needle because the stitches aren't pulling through. See, I see it even. I have a sliver that is stuck on the wool. Well, that's never good. So I'm just going to move all the stitches over to this other needle and just take a closer look here at this sliver that I kind of just pulled out, but is still kind of hanging everything up. I might actually have to get some sandpaper out. I might have to switch back over to the metal needles and get sandpaper out. Everything up here to the other side and see what's going on in that spot. Okay, so they're over there. So it's right here. Like you can see where the yarn fuzz kind of got onto it. And it's definitely, oh yeah, it's definitely snaggable. Let me compare it to the other one that I put away. This one I just didn't like how it was a little bit rough where the printed numbers were. So I'm going to try to continue on with this one. And I'll just make a note of myself that the other one has a big snag spot on it. This is the nature of wood needles. It happens. You don't want to go to work at the hotel? Okay, well just quit, Robbie. Just call up your boss and say, that's it, I'm done, I quit. Why don't you want to go work? That's like a super easy job. Maybe if you learn to knit, you can knit at work. Then you would have something to do to pass the time. I got a bunch of extra knitting needles. Would you like me to send you a set? And then you can knit your own hats for your giant melon head. Custom fit for yourself. I'm sleepy. Yeah, I'm sleepy too. I was considering taking a nap today. See, I struggle with this because I always want to take a nap like an hour before my children come home from school. But an hour nap is not enough time for me. I need a 3-hour nap. If I'm going to nap, I need 3 hours. That's just how my naps are. I can't do those 20-minute power naps that people do. I mean, does that actually work for you, Robbie? Like, can you lay down back there, nap, and then, like, someone rings the bell and you just come out and help them? I'd be so cranky. I'd be super cranky if my nap kept getting interrupted and woken up and stuff. Be like, what do you want? Fuck you, you can't have a room. Get out of here. Be so grouchy. Like, my 3-hour nap must be uninterrupted. Princess, I have princess naps. Discombobulate it. Right, I believe that was row 4. Double check here. Yeah. It's not so bad. But yeah, if you can handle it, it wouldn't be so bad. I wouldn't be able to handle it. I'd be cranky. Because I know how I am any other time I've tried taking naps and they get interrupted. If you can snooze and then customers ring the bell and you're fine, then that's excellent. You're going to make coffee and you'll put up a sold out sign. Robbie, if your motel goes out of business, then you don't have a job anymore. So I do not recommend that. Do not recommend a out of business or all sold out sign. I think, Robbie, you just need more activities to do at work while you're there. If you're not going to knit or crochet or color or something, like, you need something to do. You need a hobby, Robbie. Start a whole segment called Robbie Finds a Hobby. Then you can call yourself Hobby Robbie. Besides watching clips and yelling at them, a different hobby, a positive hobby, a hobby that brings you joy. curls are your hobby? The hotel makes their money selling out on weekends. That's true. Probably weekends are all that matter, really. Oh, sorry for the yawning. But you can't, like, I mean, I guess you can exercise your hobby while you're working. You can, you know, search for girls and talk to girls and do that, I guess. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. That's your hobby. I'm gonna step back a little. Just for a minute or two. Gotta think about this picked up edge. Tell Robbie I'm working so hard on our poster competition too. The starting a new knitting project was eating my brain, and I couldn't focus on our posters until the brain eating got resolved. You used to have girls come over to the hotel all the time. They replaced the video system because it kept going down in the middle of the night. Not maybe the kind of confessional you need to share, Robbie. Yeah, I'm sure it would be super convenient. Because you kept unplugging it. Yes, yes. No, you don't need to spell it out anymore. I understand what you meant. I think one more before we do the cast on edge. Or the pick up the edge. One more round. Alexa, skip. Okay, we don't need to listen to Moonlight Sonata either because that's super popular. The little bit we have and how it looks, probably. I mean, I have my resolution set so low so that it can compensate for my meh internet service. Tell you guys now can't see it, that it's fuzzy. Probably because I have it focusing on something else. Somewhere when I was starting up this live stream, I bumped the like lock focus, and I don't know where to switch it back to like autofocus. Nobody needs to see anything in focus. Everything could be blurry. But yeah, I think the focus is set up to like right about here somewhere. Check my time. Okay, I'm still good for time. But I think I'm going to wrap up. You just tap on the screen until the lock turns white again. You know what, Robbie? We're going to test that here in a moment. Because I've done it a couple times. Where I've accidentally tap the screen and then it's locked the focus. Does I need a stretch break? Turns white. It just turns yellow, 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 yellow. Like even if I tap in the same place, it's just all yellow. Oh wait, maybe it's doing like a lock and unlock thing. Well, at least, you know, I can show you guys the knitting up close and zoom in and stuff. So there's the knitting. Look, you can see it now. Maybe it's a press and hold. Ooh, press and hold. I think I turned it. There. So there's the knitting so far. Kind of see it. But yeah, now that I'm here. Robbie, it wasn't a tap until it turns white. It was a press and hold, but thank you. But now that I'm standing up and I'm here, I can hit my end button. So thanks you guys for hanging out. Here, I'll even pick up my mic. Thanks you guys for hanging out. Hope you have a great evening. Hope you have a good night at work, Robbie. I might pop in later. And I'll see you guys next time, probably tomorrow, because that's just how it goes. So have a good night.